My name is Amy McKinnon, and I'm one of the reporters on the reveal episode, Russia's New Scapegoats. So as we were making our plans to do this show, I was already booking in interviews in St. Petersburg and looking at my travel options. I heard that the Russian journalist Dmitry Silikin had been murdered in the city. And it became very clear from police reports and reports in the local press that this was a homophobic killing. And this added a real sense of urgency to the story that we were doing, that this is still an issue that affects people's lives every day in Russia and the region. So given some of the people that I was going to be interviewing, one of the concerns we had for my part of the reporting was safety. And one of the more memorable sections of my part of the show is the interview with Timur Bulatov, a vigilante who gets LGBT teachers fired from their jobs. And the whole setup was just deeply unsettling. He changed the location of our interview at the very last minute. It was in this completely empty office building in this tiny cramped room, and about halfway through the interview I was kind of looking around behind him and I noticed a gun sat on the table next to him. I was holding up the recorder in my hand and the shot of adrenaline just fired down my arm, and I tried to, you know, not let him know, not let on that I'd seen it, to keep asking questions, listening to what he's saying, and trying to push him as much as I could with my questions but without wanting to provoke him.
Over the years, I've done lots of reporting about gay rights abuses around the world, and I believe that it is undoubtedly the very front line of a larger battle for human rights. Coda Story is a non-profit newsroom that puts a team of journalists on one story at a time, and we cover it from many different angles, and we really focus on creating context around the events that shape our world. So we wanted to answer, why did Putin pick gays as the enemies? What we discovered was fascinating. First of all, we discovered that the decision to target gays did come from the very top. Secondly, it was a very pragmatic decision, and the Kremlin has managed to turn homophobia into a major soft power tool for Russia, both at home and abroad. We attended and covered an extraordinary event in Tbilisi, Georgia. It's called the World Congress of Families. In one of the most amazing moments of that conference, this American Orthodox priest from California, at some point he quoted from the Quran the passage which he said called on gays to be killed, and people applauded. It was chilling, it was disturbing to cover it, it was disturbing to be there, but I think it was also very important.
I'm Catherine Miskowski from Reveal. I was the lead producer on this episode.
Credit companies.
With every reveal show, we have to ask, why would Americans care? And in this episode, there are so many reasons.
Now right-wing activists, different groups of people call themselves traditionalists, rise up. And if you are gay, lesbian, especially transgender, you will be not only beaten, but you will be killed.
In this show, we demonstrated what it's like to live in a post-factual environment where myths, not facts, are being spread about you, and what the real-world consequences of that are. What Amy and Natalia uncovered is that this anti-gay campaign is not bubbling up organically from the population. It's actually top-down, that the state-run media in Russia is promoting anti-gay ideas. Since this show aired, it's unfortunately become more relevant than ever. News broke of gay men being rounded up, imprisoned, and tortured in Chechnya, and other post-Soviet states have launched their own campaign against gays and lesbians.